Now to our Commitment 2014 political coverage, and tonight our AdWatch team is back to put another campaign commercial to the truth test.
KCRA3's David Beenig joining us now with an ad that claims Prop 46 contains security risks to our privacy, David.
Yeah, that's right. First, a reminder, KCRA3 is doing AdWatch in partnership with Sacramento State's Project for an Informed Electorate. And this time the project has provided us with these experts, public policy professor Charles Gossett, public policy professor Mary Kirlin, and government studies professor Kimberly Nalder. They're grading each ad for its truthfulness, its substance, and its relevance to the issues that voters care about. And tonight, their grades are in for the ad that wants you to vote no on Proposition 46.
A troubling provision that puts your...
This ad features computer sound effects, images of hackers working in dark rooms, and this claim about Proposition 46.
Shh, there's a secret inside Proposition 46.
It's not secret that I know of. It's right there in black and white.
In fact, the text that the ad highlights comes from the official voter summary of Prop 46, which is distributed to every registered voter in the entire state.
I don't know how that can be a secret if it's in the summaries.
Everything in an initiative is a secret, right? Because no one reads them.
In this case, the so-called secret is a computer database.
Prop 46 requires doctors to consult a vulnerable government-run database containing your personal prescription drug history.
The database the ad refers to is called CURES, the Controlled Substance Utilization Review and Evaluation System. Since 1996, pharmacists have been using it to document each time they fill a prescription. Not for all drugs, just certain drugs vulnerable to abuse, such as OxyContin and Vicodin.
So that they are, in theory, can be monitoring of potential folks who are going to several doctors in a row and getting the same prescription and therefore getting a supply that either could be sold illegally or otherwise abused.
Right now, when doctors write prescriptions, they can consult the database, but they're not required to do so. Prop 46 would force doctors to check the database when writing a prescription for the first time.
But the database already exists?
It already exists, yes.
Will it go away if Prop 46 fails?
No, it will not. Right, the database itself is not on the ballot. It's just how much we check it.
The ad calls it a vulnerable database.
Open to law enforcement, hackers, identity thieves, or simply accidents.
On screen, there's a reference to a hacking incident at a hospital chain. But our ad watchers say it's not fair to compare the computer security of a private hospital chain to the security of the California Department of Justice, which operates the prescription database. In fact, of the 48 states that have similar databases, there's been just one reported case in Virginia where a hacker broke in.
We can never say that any database is 100% hacker-proof, but I don't think there's any special reason to believe that this would be a treasure trove of information for hackers either.
It's not like it's got credit card information.
What our ad watchers like least about this ad is that the prescription database requirement is a relatively small part of Proposition 46.
It's not the big banana. It's not the whole picture for sure.
Prop 46 would also do two other major things. It would raise the cap on how much money juries can award patients in medical malpractice cases, and it would require drug and alcohol testing for doctors.
The big aspects of this initiative are just omitted entirely.
So, how do our ad watchers grade the truthfulness of this ad?
Is it a complete fabrication? Pretty close.
So, on truthfulness, a grade of D+. As for how much substance and useful information the ad contains,
it's almost nothing more than a scare tactic. If you even listen to the music that's playing in the background, you're expecting someone to jump out from a corner at you.
So on substance, the ad gets its lowest grade, D-. Finally, on how relevant it is to voters.
The issue of security and online security matters to us.
But our ad watchers say Prop 46 is not really about online security, and the ad isn't much about Prop 46. So, for relevance, C-.
The ad isn't about the central part of the initiative, the reason it's on the ballot, what everyone's actually fighting about. And so it's really sort of this misleading emotional sideshow.
A misleading emotional sideshow. Here again are the grades for this No on 46 ad. D+ for truthfulness, D- for substance, and a C- for how relevant it is to voters. Two D's and a C's. I can't help but think of that town that they're always talking about on public radio, that town in Minnesota where all the kids are above average. All our ads in California seem to be below average this year.
Ooh, yeah, all of our ads need to go to summer school, sounds like. All right, David, thanks.
Well, we should also let you know that there's a Yes on 46 ad that's begun showing up. We're going to talk a little bit more of that and the claims of that in future reports with David. Great job on those. And